Okay, so in this video I'll be talking about fake power banks and why you should never ever buy fake power banks compared to real power banks. I mean original genuine power banks. Okay, so let's start off with the Xiaomi 10,400 mAh one we have here. This is a fake one. The easier to tell is the dark letterings. Original ones, they have light letterings like this. Okay, so just a quick crash course. These power banks, they all use lithium ion cells. Lithium ion, they are inherently unstable in terms of chemistry. So if there is a flaw in the manufacturing, they can short and they can explode very easily. So this is a Xiaomi, fake Xiaomi power bank. This one is supposing 10,400 mAh, but it can only charge a phone once. Yeah, once. 10,400 mAh, you can charge a phone once. So yeah, let's see what's inside. As you can see, it's quite easy to open up. The original power bank is not this easy to open up. It's slightly more complicated. And the build quality is also questionable. You can see these cells are unbranded. These are 18650 lithium ion cells. There are no brandings on it. There are no markings, writings. You can see they are blank. So you cannot trace where these cells come from. And you can't know what's the actual capacity of it, the rated capacity. This could be old cells, or this could be manufactured as cheaper, low capacity cells. All I know is that they're shit. And you can see the board. I can see it's quite blank. The original one I've opened before is not this blank. You can search for pictures online. So yeah, this one is quite new actually, but the capacity from new is already crap. So this cell from an original Xiaomi battery. This is an LGB4 cell. My old power bank, the USB port had died. So what I did is I harvested the cells, and now I can use it in my flashlight. This flashlight uses 18650 cells as well. And now I have tons of spare cells for basically free. Okay, let's talk about this Penang power bank. Penang is a quite famous brand in Malaysia. I have quite a number of friends using them. This one here is a fake. How do you know? It's that you just search the number and just put it in the website. And this particular unit checks out as the number does not exist. This one actually got it as a gift, but it's a fake. So yeah, this power bank is almost brand new. Supposedly 20,000 mAh, but it cannot even charge a phone. It cannot even charge a phone to full. One, same like the fake Xiaomi power bank, but that's 10,000. This is 20,000. I can't charge the phone to full. So let's see what's inside. This is quite heavy though. So this, I had already opened the power bank previously, so that's why it looks easy to open. And same as the Xiaomi fake power bank, these are unbranded cells as well. You can see there's a brand logo and there's a model number for the circuit board, but I cannot find information on that as well. Just put that one aside. Okay, let's talk about the worst one here. This is a fake Yubao power bank. This one supposedly 13,000 mAh capacity. This is supposedly have 5 18650s here, but let's see what's inside. There's only 3, as you can see. There's 2 cells here that's missing. I have heard some power banks, some fake power banks, they actually replace it with sandbags, but this one just left it blank. So over the years, you can see this power bank is about 4 to 5 years old, but the cells had already vented and leaked. And the things that leak out, they are quite corrosive. You can see it corroded the metal terminals of the battery. So yeah, it's not connected anymore. This power bank is useless. And this one is quite a lucky case actually. Lucky because it just vented and leaked with no incidents. Imagine if it happened in your car. You left it under the sun, and with enough, the temperature will cause the cells to build up pressure inside it. And usually the branded cells, they have a vent valve. But for the cheaper cells, some of them might not have one. And so what happened is the pressure will build up inside the battery. And with enough pressure, they will explode. Yeah. Okay, so this one here is actually an original Yubao power bank, just to show you. This one here is also 4 to 5 years old. But this one is a lot better built than the fake ones, obviously. I actually tried to open it, but I gave up because you can see there's a lot of pry marks here. I actually tried to pry it out, but it won't budge. Well, anyway, this power bank is still good. Still works. It's 4 to 5 years old now. Supposing 15,600 capacity, but I think the capacity had dropped to around 10,000 to 11,000 mAh, which is not too bad considering it's so old, but it still works. Only thing, I think one USB port had died, but the other one is still functioning, and the torch still works somehow. Ah, it's great. Okay, this now the latest power banks, they are mostly using lithium polymer, at least for Xiaomi. Most of their newer power banks are all using lithium polymer batteries. Basically, just imagine a larger version of your phone battery. Yeah, so they stuff that into a slim case, and this is much easier to carry around than, say, something like this older style 18650 style power bank. So yeah, just avoid all this cheap crap, avoid all these fake power banks, and just invest in a good power bank. Can last you for years. For example, like this original Yubao, where I bought it, is quite expensive, but 4 to 5 years down it's still running. Compared to this, this one is about 20 ringgit, 20-30 ringgit, you can get it now. But this Xiaomi power bank, this is about 70 ringgit. Just spend a bit more, get an original power bank. It won't fail you, and you can actually get the maximum capacity out of these batteries. As you can see, this fake batteries, they are nowhere near their rated capacity, and basically it's a ripoff. Okay, thank you for watching. I hope this video proved you informational. And I hope that you will not buy fake power banks. Okay, thank you for watching and have a nice day.